Iranian presidential elections tend to be unfree, unfair, and unpredictable. But this time around, it's more predictable than in the past, and that it's increasingly looking like it's going to be one man, one vote, and that man is the Ayatollah Khamenei, the supreme leader. And I think what he's done this time around is rig the candidates in advance, you know, eight candidates, all of whom he's okay with. And I would compare it somewhat akin to having a presidential election in the United States in which only members of the Tea Party can participate. So there is diversity amongst the candidates. There is competition in that all of them want to be president, but none of the fundamental issues in Iran have been raised. You know, why are we supporting Bashar al-Assad in Syria? Why are we spending billions of dollars in Syria when we could be spending that money at home? Why are we pursuing this retrograde nuclear program, which has cost us over $100 billion in economic sanctions and lost foreign investment, when we could be pursuing a more conciliatory global approach? So those types of questions aren't being raised in this election.